I'm proud to present, coming straight to you from a beautiful villa in Rome, Italy, the world's very first noodle chair.
A portion of this video was sponsored by LastPass. Now let's go. Vsauce, Kevin here with a very simple engineering project. All you need is a foam disc, some spaghetti, and suddenly you're demonstrating the compressive strength that allows tiny rods of pasta to hold up the weight of a hardcover book. When I saw this, I thought to myself, what if I'm the book? Can pasta hold me? And then LastPass came along and they said, Kevin, we'd like to work with you on creating your dream video. And I said, my dream is to build a noodle chair in Italy. And they said, ha ha ha, no, but really. And I said, ha ha ha, yes, but really. So I'm gonna do it. I am literally going to fly to Italy and build a chair out of noodles. While I travel over 4,000 miles to Rome, let me thank LastPass for sponsoring this video. If you don't know about LastPass, I use it for all my logins. I was tired of forgetting passwords, getting locked out of accounts, or dealing with websites that have different rules about what a password could even be. So I got LastPass and it automatically fills my usernames and passwords everywhere, safely and securely, with unlimited password storage and cross-device sync. Thanks again to LastPass for sponsoring this portion of the video. So if you want to eliminate your password frustrations forever, click the link down in the description below. I am in Rome. And if you're gonna build a chair out of noodles, you need to hire the big guns. So I've flown in two competitors from the World Spaghetti Bridge Building Championship in Budapest, Hungary. Introducing
Norbert Locky and Jonathan Lokatos.
They're here from Óbuda University to represent RECH, the annual World Championships in Spaghetti Bridge Building, where using just spaghetti and epoxy, competitors build bridges that support hundreds of times their own weight.
These Goliaths of gluten truly are pasta engineers, and it's time to procure the noodles that we need to hold my hiney.
We all jumped in a taxi from the villa to the supermarket to get our pasta. I mean, we're in Italy. There's no reason to bring your own noodles from home, right? Wrong. That was a mistake. In the World Championships, Johnny and Norbi use pure durum wheat pasta for its amazing strength. They panicked when all they could find at the market was cannelloni with egg added to it. It honestly never occurred to me that an entire aisle filled with pasta wouldn't have what the guys were looking for. But it didn't.
What are you looking for? What is the difference?
This without eggs.
Without eggs?
Without eggs.
What's plan B?
We kindly asked an employee to help us find eggless noodles, but even with the language barrier, it was pretty clear we weren't going to find the cannelloni we needed. Here's why it's a problem. Egg is added to pasta to help give it a yellow color, to add some additional nutritional value, and to influence water absorption. But it also changes the pasta's structure. Egg noodles are more brittle than what Norbi and Johnny usually use. In materials science, brittleness matters. It's the measure of how much stress a material can absorb before breaking. Durum wheat? Strong. Egg? But we didn't have any other choice. It was egg or nothing. Our only course of action was to grab life by the yolks and call upon Ceres, the Roman goddess of agriculture and wheat, to bless our egg-fortified noodles. If our pleas go unanswered, what's the worst that could happen? I fall through the chair and break my tailbone? Okay, that would be bad. Please hold, egg cannelloni, please.
All right, so we're back from the store on our epic pasta run, and here's what we've got. We've got
5 boxes of bucatini, 16 boxes of cannelloni, 1 box of lasagna, 1 bag of extra long spaghetti, 5 boxes of epoxy, 1 tube of silicone, 5 boxes of super fast epoxy, a bag of silicone discs, a pile of wooden support blocks, a digital caliper, various tools, and 6 metal dowels that were supposed to be wooden dowels, but, well, here's a little reenactment of what happened when we found out no one brought wooden dowels.
Norbi, hand me a dowel.
I didn't bring the dowels. Did you bring the dowels?
I thought you brought the dowels.
Why do you guys need dowels?
to make straight tubes like this.
You can break my light stand apart if you like.
Anyway, now that we have everything that we need to create our magnificent noodle chair, that means it's time for one thing and one thing only, and that is to whip out our noodles.
We've absorbed egg adversity. We've dealt with a dowel disaster. Against all odds, it was finally time to start building our noodle chair. First, let's talk about the sticky stuff. We're using epoxy because it's not a water-based adhesive. That way it won't soak into the noodles and compromise their integrity. It also creates rigid joints that transfer force to the noodles, because we want the noodles themselves to bear all the weight. A chair made entirely out of epoxy resin would support thousands of pounds, but that kind of defeats the purpose of what we're doing here. We want to push the limits of pasta, and we don't have a lot of time. Because epoxy takes a full 24 hours to cure, Norbi and Johnny needed to build fast. So Norbi and Johnny started by building the chair's seat out of meticulously selected pieces of cannelloni, a cylindrical noodle that's often filled with ricotta cheese. We're not, however, gonna fill our chair with cheese. We're not gonna fill our chair with cheese. They've gone through box after box to find the best shaped cannelloni, so their grind of the most consistent noodles will have the highest structural integrity. You know what they say, one wonky noodle and we've got a serious weak point. Nobody says that. And that's when a quality control calamity struck. It turned out one brand of the cannelloni that we bought was almost completely worthless because nearly all of the noodles were misshapen and most of the nicely shaped ones had cracks. We needed perfect cylinders, so in an instant our supply of materials was cut in half. At this point, we officially had no room for error. The top and bottom layers are composed of 14 three-noodle rows, and the top layer is rotated 90 degrees to cross the grain like a plywood composite. This increases the stiffness of the material, which is a measure of its ability to resist deformation from an applied force. In this case, my butt. The seat will transfer the force to three legs, each of which are comprised of three pipes of cannelloni. Every piece is sanded carefully so the joined surfaces are as close to perfect as possible. And then they're constructed into a tube using our tripod dowels as a mold and jig. The three tubes are then attached to make a chair leg that distributes force through one of the strongest shapes in engineering, an equilateral triangle. Norbi and Johnny worked straight through until 5 a.m. planning, measuring, grinding, and gluing, until they finished what they needed to. And as the sun rose over Roma, the hard-working Hungarians collapsed.
Buongiorno. It is now day two. Noodle construction went on until 5 a.m. this morning, and the lingering question I have in my mind is this. Why does boiling pasta turn a hard thing soft, but boiling an egg turns a soft thing hard? Weirdly enough, both processes are the result of the same thing, water retention. Let's start with the egg.
The proteins in eggs, mostly albumin, are compacted with weak bonds. Think of them like clumps of cord that don't really interact with each other. When heated, the collision with excited water molecules makes them all smash together and those bonds break, causing the proteins to unfold. Then the unfolded proteins tangle all together, creating new bonds.
There's still a lot more water present than protein, but the water is now divided up among countless little pockets in the continuous protein network, so it can't flow together anymore, and thus a liquid egg has become a moist solid.
Moist solid sounds gross.
Okay, but why does boiling spaghetti make it soft?
Because it rehydrates the pasta.
Oh, okay, cool. Wait, what does that mean?
Well, uncooked pasta is basically a zillion raw starch granules embedded in a matrix of gluten protein. When cooked in water, starch granules at and near the noodle surface absorb water, swell, soften, and release some dissolved starch into the cooking water. This process is called gelatinization, and we can visualize this using superabsorbent polymer spheres. Just imagine these spheres are the starch granules inside the spaghetti, rehydrating it into these soft, delicious noodles ready for saucing.
Let's get back to our chair.
And day two is when Johnny and Norbi decided to radically change the chair's design. Their original plan was to build a chair with three legs crossed in mutual support. Early on the second day, they decided to add a fourth leg for a more traditional chair. That meant building another leg that we hoped would dry and cure in time to be tested. Because with so many problems and gambles already, why not push our luck? Then, it was bucatini time. Bucatini is like a thick spaghetti with a hole in the middle, so it was the perfect choice for a top layer for the seat that could evenly distribute downward force to the cannelloni layer. Johnny and Norbi braced the bucatini with strips of lasagna for even more strength. Oh, and a chair needs a back, doesn't it? It does. They put together a simple open back with rows of noodles similar to the seat. The joint between the back and the seat just isn't going to be very strong without many layers of lasagna, so this one's gonna be, delicate. But just as you'd expect, the legs are pretty much everything when it comes to holding my weight. If the legs don't work, the chair don't work. So they attached the legs to the seat using silicone pads to give a bit more surface area to make up for the gaps between the cannelloni. Then it was about leg to floor contact. They precision sanded the feet to just the right angle so that all four would rest evenly on the floor. If just one leg is too far off, the downward force from my body will be distributed unevenly, which means the other legs will have to absorb additional stress, and that's bad. With the egg noodle uncertainty, a dwindling supply of acceptable cannelloni, and the clock ticking on epoxy curing time, they used extra long spaghetti to attach flat support beams between the four cannelloni legs. Look, when you're quickly building a noodle chair, every little bit helps. Here's a question. Why are we using cannelloni?
We chose cannelloni because they're a lot like these Ionic columns from Greek and Roman architecture. Now, when building noodle furniture, some of the things to consider are the noodle's tensile strength, which is its ability to resist tension that will elongate and break it. Then compressive strength, which is withstanding force that compresses the noodle. And then its shear strength, which is its ability to handle parallel forces acting upon it.
It's crunch time. It's the 11th hour. The sun is going down soon, and we need to test this chair. We all have flights to catch. With the back assembled to the seat and the legs as sturdy and precise as they can get from our incorrect noodles, we're finally ready to— Oh God, the back broke! Yeah, so the back has just broken off our noodle chair. We didn't even see what happened. One minute it was great, the other minute it was not. We didn't even get it on video because there was nothing to film. We weren't gonna record hours of glue drying. But despite the back tragedy, Norbi and Johnny scrambled to reattach and reinforce the back so we'd be ready for testing. And finally, to finish things off, we added a little spaghetti flair. Hey, we're in Italy. Design matters. The Flavian dynasty built Rome's Colosseum. Michelangelo painted the ceiling of the Sistine Chapel in Vatican City. And here, in a cozy Roman villa, Norbi and Johnny present to me their noodle chair.
Well, there it is. We're done. What do you think?
I hope it supports you. I think it will.
I'm proud to present, coming straight to you from a beautiful villa in Rome, Italy, the world's very first noodle chair! To make this video, I assembled a team from Budapest, Hungary, Bristol, England, Cooperstown, New York, and Las Vegas, Nevada. Collectively, we traveled 47,776 kilometers. That's 7,701 kilometers more than the circumference of Earth, to a 3-acre villa in the heart of Rome, Italy. And we spent day and night building a chair out of noodles. And now, for the very first time, none of us have tested this yet, I'm gonna sit on it. And if it works, it works! And if it doesn't work... well... here we go.
It works! Yeah!
It totally works! We have a noodle chair!
Lean back, see what the back's like.
It totally worked. Great job, guys. Well, now what?
Where are you going, Kevin? Mentre il giorno non c'è più e la luna da lassù fa da specchio ai nostri baci.
Oh! Se ti guardo dentro agli occhi mentre già mi batte il cuore e ti dico che per me stare insieme qui con te ho il sapore dell'amore.
And as always, mio caro amore, se tu mi baci, caro l'amore, sei tu.
Thanks for watching. Baci, baci di amore, mi baci. This is Hungarian engineering at its finest. Still works. I gotta brace myself. It's going down. Well, it turns out if you dunk a noodle chair in a pool and then sit on it, it will break. The end. E mi perdo nei tuoi baci, dentro il cuore si mi bruci, come il sole d'estate ti voglio. Thanks to Norbi and Johnny and the Wretch World Spaghetti Building Championship, and huge thanks to Dom Burgess for shooting this whole thing. He has a science YouTube channel called Every Think. I'll put a link down in the description below. He's got a video on how to build a time machine, how when we find aliens, they'll be robots. You wanna go subscribe to Every Think. If you liked this video, I mean, I thought it was a lot of fun to make. Let me know if you'd like to see more stuff like this. And as always, grazie for watching.